Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the We Don't Know How to Tell Our Friends What's Going On group chat.
Hello,
podcast.
Everybody.
And
also, you're already starting off toxic.
You're crying.
There's a weird theme going on.
We have zero topics, a donut hole of topics.
There is a weird theme going on here.
There's one cry baby, and that's it.
Viewers at home, you will not know. YouTube watchers will know. There seems to be a theme.
The faceless YouTuber wants to not be faceless anymore.
Yeah, he's crying because he can't wear a costume, even though he doesn't even turn his camera on.
I was fucking shopping. I had two little idiots go and dress up for Halloween.
Wow, we dressed up for Halloween? I'm sorry.
Do it.
I put on a costume.
The viewers at home, sorry, I forgot.
Yummy's a strawberry.
I'm a strawberry.
Viewers at home, I had no time to prepare.
Oh, you know what I look like? Did you see the episode of SpongeBob when the Flying Dutchman, SpongeBob wished for him to be a vegetarian and then SpongeBob would turn into a strawberry?
Oh, you're right.
Dude, that's literally me right now.
Oh, you're right.
SpongeBob! Come on!
And, what is on your head,
drunk?
Wait.
Drunk is a chopper. A
oh. I'm Chopper.
Who is that, bitch?
It's Maria it's Joy.
Maria. You just called Santa Maria a bitch?
Yeah. What is wrong with you?
Is that the virgin?
Is that the virgin? Do not curse around her.
No, that's the town hooker. Dude, she literally had a baby.
Bro, you're going straight to hell.
That's not even God or nothing,
Do you know
bro.
Who you're in a call with, young man?
Sorry. Yeah, but welcome the Virgin back, Mary was not a virgin. I can say that podcast, much.
Episode 28.
I know how sex works.
No way.
Today I'm joined by my friends and we are all dressed up, or most of us are, and some of us didn't get
the memo. It's our seventh month in a row
and we've never missed a week and no one has ever missed a podcast.
Nobody's missed a podcast. We just keep going.
So Larry's an angel, Tanner's a nun, Nick dressed up as a dumbass, I'm a strawberry. Drunk is Chopper.
Holy stray.
That was a straight bullet, my slime.
Thank you, GamerSubs, for sponsoring this episode.
Thank you, GamerSubs. Thank you.
What's Isaac dressed up as if I'm dressed up as an idiot?
Isaac dressed up as something horrible.
Dumb and Dumber.
We have GamerSubs, Gamer Moan. Code group 10% off.
There we go.
Actually, fun fact, we changed our code to Misfits.
No, we didn't. Don't do that.
Please don't listen to them.
Misfits, they got deleted, so they can only use code group now.
Viewers at home, if you use code Misfits,
you actually have to pay
$200. What is wrong with you?
Yeah, it doubles the price.
For the viewers at home, if you use code group fart, you would actually get a plus $10, which means that you would round up to an additional $10.
Now, okay, that's also not true.
That is a lie, and I just lied to you. So how do you feel about being gaslighted? Let's talk about gaslighting people, man.
Let's talk about how you feel after that.
Wow, that's segue. Easy.
Okay, I feel like gaslighting people is like, it's only right if it's a joke.
I think gaslighting is overplayed.
You said what?
Gaslighting. No, it's overplayed. Like, people pull that shit out of their ass.
What are you
like,
talking about?
People just like will blanket everything as gaslighting.
Yeah, yummy.
Yummy. Hey, you don't know what you're talking about. Yummy, you're acting really weird.
We're not doing that.
We're not doing that right now, yummy.
We're not doing that.
You're so weird right now. Do you not know anything?
I don't know what you're talking about, yummy.
Like, are you feeling okay? I think that kind of just might be like seeping into your fucking brain.
I think this is you, man. Not us. This is definitely you.
Whatever.
I'm not being gaslit.
Yummy. No, you want to hear some gaslighting? I'm literally not wearing pants right now.
Stop.
That's just a lie.
Stop! No!
Okay,
no!
Guys.
For the viewers at home, it's blurred!
Oh, thank God.
Okay, we've been gaslit.
We have been gaslit.
You've been gaslit.
Cam, can you take Grunk's pants off and post editing?
Okay, but unlike Cam, I am actually not wearing pants.
Whoa, your boobies are restricted, dude.
We just heard you're nuts.
Sorry.
You probably think you're a girl.
Viewers at home, do you want to guess whose costume Larry's wearing? Mine, and I was going to wear it next week, but he has it on.
How does it fit you? I did already fit in it.
It doesn't. I can see his nuts. You want to see them?
You can see his nuts and balls. You can see his penis.
It's because Isaac's chest is tiny.
Isaac's chest is...
I have a barrel chest. Whoa, that was like Jesus.
Today Isaac and I were at the gym and he's like, look at these. And I was like, yeah, man, look at that. And I pointed to his chest and he's like,
it connects.
It connects. It goes like this and tries to put them together. It connects.
All right, well, dude, I'm sorry I wasn't fucking 400 pounds when I was 8 years old. I have a whole shit ton of muscle.
Fun fact, I was a lineman at 10 years old and I weighed 100 pounds. You were a
tight end at age 4.
No, he was center at age
1. What'd you say about my tight end at age 4? What'd you just say?
Whoa!
I was a wide receiver at age 4.
Are we talking about something serious right now?
I was center at age 4.
Are you serious right now, bro? Are you?
Welcome to the worst podcast.
Incoming title and thumbnail. The Goofy Aw Podcast. Try not to laugh.
Try not to laugh. Yeah. The goofiest Halloween episode ever.
Tell me about your day.
Podcast related topic. Did you guys see about Joe Rogan getting dethroned by Markiplier's?
Dethroned?
What the
fuck? What kind of medieval shit are you talking about?
It was his OnlyFans, right?
Podcast toppings. It was like the chart tops.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because of Markiplier's OnlyFans.
What do you know about that?
Is he actually going to get naked?
I want to see some of hard dick in my life.
I hope so.
Wait, okay. I'm going to look up if he got naked on the nude calendar.
On the nude calendar?
What is the nude calendar?
He has a nude calendar. And all the money went to charity. Yeah, all the money went to charity, I think.
Did he show his butt?
I don't think it was a nude. I don't think he was actually nude, though.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, it's like fake nude.
Was he side piping? Was he just side piping?
I'm looking now.
Does he talk funny in his videos?
Hello, everybody. My name is Markiplier.
And then Jacksepticeye would be like, whoops.
And people are like,
what we got?
We got Quibble Cop, but
Larry, do you have a
Quibble Cop? Be like, okay, I'm gonna now get four of you.
Okay, now I'm going to. Your eyes like glow, like they're white.
Oh yeah, they are.
Dude, did you like bleach your eyes?
Wait, watch this.
You look edited all the fucking time.
What?
What is wrong with your?
You look like a fucking. You look like a Mr. Beast thumbnail.
Yeah, dude.
Your eyes are that white.
Hello. You don't even need to be edited.
Can we get a picture of that? That is like
what
perfect.
The fuck? Actually,
wait. On.
Angle it more and then put something
stand,
in the door.
Stand. For the viewers at home, I am now standing. Okay.
No, come back.
Dude, you
have to.
Like a little
no, come back.
Freak.
You have to. No, no, come back. No. I'm not doing it. No, it has to be right here. You have to be like.
Dude, he's got broad shoulders.
He does. No, he looks fucking huge right now.
It's an illusion. It's the camera.
The corset's an extra small.
I'll be real. Larry's been looking big recently.
Dave,
dude,
put this back up there.
I'm so sorry.
We're actually going to get demonetized.
To the viewers at home, Larry is listeners.
I'm naked.
Whoever
he's letting his boobies hang out.
He honestly has like saggy boobs and they're
triple,
coming out of his fucking corset.
Fucking
I have sags? I do not, actually.
No, I'm sorry. I'm
don't
the
check,
one with triple fucking G's.
Hold on, guys.
Tanner, you fill that. You fill that
out. I fill the fuck out of this. It doesn't.
No, you do more than fill it, dude. You're expanding that shit out.
You deadlift, it rips.
You know what Tanner looks like? Tanner looks like the sexy nun from Nacho Libre.
Is there a sexy nun in Nacho Libre?
There is a sexy nun from Nacho Libre.
That's not very sister-like.
You look like Dave the Barbarian.
Wait, yeah, it's the...
Oh, wait. Wasn't there like a... Kate Upton, what was she in? She was in like...
GTA 5.
Sports Illustrated.
Stories.
GTA 5.
I think she was like my first
the movie with Adam Sandler when he has a remote.
Your first what, buddy?
Like my first like quote unquote celebrity crush like everybody else at that
Stacey's
age.
Mom.
Yeah, you let me guess you used iFunny like once.
Stacey's mom.
Actually, I remember using iFunny for those pictures.
That is real as fuck.
Yeah, and she was wearing the American like flag like bra.
Wasn't that like the top bikini? It was like the top most rated picture of like all time for like 4 years on iFunny.
She was like the queen of iFunny and Will Ferrell
was
the king.
She was literally just a meme.
Will Ferrell was the king.
Will Ferrell was the king of iFunny. Kate Upton was the queen.
That is real.
Weird. Dude.
Anyways, guys, Halloween is approaching dangerously fast and I want an outfit and now I don't have one. So
seven.
Any guesses? I do have seven, but I'm going to pretend I don't.
Dude, we're in fucking October. What the fuck?
Oh my effing! OM double effing G.
It's 2022.
OM double effing G. It's October.
Can you believe because
that 2018
was
9 years ago?
Huh?
Oh yeah, because we're like 1 month behind, like the time zones.
No, I think it's because like in Texas, there's just not like much difference in weather as abruptly
New
Jersey.
Can we talk about that?
Yeah, we could talk about that.
Yeah, I went home for my birthday. It was super cute seeing all my fat dogs, my fat pugs, the pug factory still running. But dude, the color of the leaves there versus here was like
fucked. I felt like I just like time traveled like
they
4 months
veiny.
In advance.
They were
because
veiny
they,
color.
Dude, they are like orange and like yellow and shit. And it sounds like I've never heard of like, fall before, but
it's turning beautiful here.
Yeah, like dude. It's I can't imagine gorgeous. What Grunk... Dude, Grunk has like the biggest backyard
in
the city.
My drive back home... Ooh-wee, it is gorgeous.
And you're like kind of in the woods. There's a lot of trees around you and shit. Mm-hmm. You got a lot there, of... I know Tanner...
You had back in Washington, all the leaves are probably already on the fucking ground. Actually, it's like 30 degrees.
No, there's like zero leaves ever. They don't even grow back. They just stay off the tree.
Yeah, that's true. They just stay off and it's always branches and trees.
Bald.
We actually don't get a lot of snow.
Points at a tree, bald...
Bald.
Nice.
What is the degrees where you live right now? What's the
right
temperature?
Now in here in Texas?
It's 40. It's 40 where I'm at.
It was 40 where I was from.
It's 44.
Too, back at home.
It's 57.
How is it colder where I'm at than where Grunk's at?
It's literally 50 in Miami.
Because you want to hear about it? My dad told me on the way here.
Yeah, what'd he say? What'd your dad say?
There's a cold front that either blew up or down. I don't know where it came from, but that's why it's been colder outside. Hey, Grunk, do me...
And we're back.
And we're back.
Hey, I don't know what's going on, everybody.
What the H?
Mr. Beast joined the call for a second. It was weird.
Mr. Beast joined and he was like...
Yeah, he was giving advice.
He was like,
what are you doing?
Sorry.
That's
no,
real.
It was because he wanted to give me a bunch of money, but he couldn't because I was 17 earlier.
Yeah,
taxes and stuff.
You're 18.
You are 18, yeah. Quit lying to people. You can like go to war and kill people like BTS. Can we just talk about that actually?
BTS.
What did BTS do?
BTS got drafted. Like BTS?
No, they didn't get drafted. They're like in
military service.
In Korea, they have to.
You have to.
Yeah, you have to enlist for like X amount of years.
And they said,
right?
Yeah.
It's pretty lame.
Porsche was enlisted.
It's like Israel.
But like, what if they came back and they performed? They're like all shaved. And like they're like marching like soldiers. And like performing, they're like,
their music sucks.
Their music's like marching,
doing like war music.
It's like old tape music. It's like,
is that like a real thing?
Yeah, BTS is doing military service, and they said they will return in 2025.
I think they have to.
My God,
I think they have to do. It's like by the age of like 25 or something like that, you have to do 2 years.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
What happens if you don't? Do you get locked up?
Yes.
I thought the K-pop industry ran the government. Like, they could probably get around that shit.
Practically.
I saw the funniest tweet ever. I saw the funniest tweet ever. It said, BTS is doing the wrong type of serve. And I kind of giggled a little bit. It was fucking sweet.
Fucking sucks.
It was fucking awesome.
That sucked.
That's so ass.
That was a Twitter top 500 best tweets moment.
That shit got stolen and got taken all over the
place. Everywhere.
You're going to see that again in like 3 months.
If you search it up, I bet you they're going to be like the same fucking right stacked up top.
Dude, right now is like the worst time for them, I feel like. You guys see the things that are happening with like North Korea, like launching more missiles near Japan. And
They've been doing that.
Russia's like really stepping up their game. In China too, dude. Like, we're getting real close to some fuck shit. Like,
when's group chat getting started? Like, drafted?
What if, like, Grunk just got, like, drafted? Like, we're all fine. What if Grunk just got drafted and we're all just sitting
that'd
here?
Be the worst.
He's the only one?
Yeah.
I want to see him in the outfit, like, holding the infant.
That would be fucking hilarious.
And then I, like, get on the battlefield and just die and you all have to
leave. He has shell
shock. On a claymore.
He comes back and he has, like, zero personality and we kick him off the podcast.
He's just like a bag of rocks.
God,
so
imagine the stories I'd have.
Dude, imagine, like, he comes back from war and then, like, his, like, caregiver has to, like, wheelchair him in to the call.
And like, GamerSubs feels bad and they make, like, a wheelchair. Like, a shaker and a cup.
He's, like, drunk, like, saluting the flag.
It's like the con. No, not kids.
What? Viewers at home.
We are a little silly today.
We are.
Yeah, we're silly. Oh,
wait. Stay on the topic of military.
Military? Okay. Anyway, my dad was in the Navy. He was in the Navy.
Viewers at home.
Do you make that for school?
I did make that for school.
Why is school making you do that?
What are you fighting for?
Yeah.
You're fucking senior.
What is happening?
I know. It's
you're like a grown man that can
like
kill somebody.
Literally, so we're doing this election project where we have to make this entire like election campaign and like that's our poster. We need to make an ad. We need to make a pamphlet. We need to
what
pick
the
four.
Fuck? Why are they making you like
what
political?
Class?
It's government.
What?
Dude, when you're like in some
so
special course or something.
No, it's just like honors government.
That is not education. Honors government.
He's in gifted classes.
It's so much. Oh, dude. I also, I'm ending AP calculus this quarter with a B. So that's
Add a kid.
You fucking brought it up.
That's where you fucking bring that shit up.
Wait, what's better, A minus or B?
Remember?
A B minus is worse than a B.
You stupid in the head.
It's like an 85.
Are you?
But,
what?
A B minus?
If you remember, like, a while, I think on a few podcasts ago, I was like, I just failed this calculus test because I literally got a 60 on it. But I brought it back. So
lore.
Yo, 69. Lore. I'm gonna give you a hint here. Go out if you have the money, which I know you do. Buy a TI Inspire. And that thing, that
I already have a calculator.
Buy the TI Inspire.
Get fucked. Here he has a calculator.
For anyone here that has their schools don't give a shit about calculators, buy a TI Inspire. It's N-S-P-I-R-E, whatever the fuck. Anyway, dude, you can literally play fucking Minecraft on it.
Why
would you buy that?
You can play Doom on it.
You can't play Doom.
That's bad advice, dude. Just buy a TI-84.
Just for fun, one time, I loaded a picture of boobies.
You can't use that at the SAT, dude. Waste of money.
Yes, you can. They let me use it at the SAT.
You did not just do that. You put boobies on your calculator?
Dude,
I used to type 8008135.
Yummy. You're right. They don't normally allow you to, but the instructor didn't give a shit, so I was able to use my Inspire on my SAT.
Dude, well, I had a runny nose.
It didn't matter. I didn't get like the greatest score.
Everybody talked to us. What?
He said I cheated on my SAT. That's not cheating. Oh. I barely used it, actually.
What was your SAT score, Nick?
1,200 something, I forget.
Mine is 1180.
What's the lowest you can get? What's the lowest score you can get?
Like 960 or something?
No, it's like 800.
Yeah, it's like 800. It's like your name. If you forget your name, then you lose. You get like a zero.
I was definitely in the 800s. I didn't make past 1,000s. I was definitely in the 800s or 900s. I can't remember.
Yeah, I did too.
Tanner,
I was
you were not
garbage.
In the 800 or 900s.
They don't even like take SATs anymore.
I was. No, that's real. I don't think I got it.
I did not do a good job on any like
the SATs.
PSAT or SAT?
SAT.
I only took the ACT.
Is that the military
got a 14
one? The ACT?
On the ACT.
I feel like 14? I got a 12.
I think I got a 29
Larry
on the ACT.
Got a 12.
That's actually really good.
900.
What?
29. Not 2900.
Holy fuck! I was like, Jesus.
You can't do that. No, ACT. The highest you can get is 36.
I didn't try whatsoever on all my tests. I'll be real. I didn't try on any of them. I didn't try on any like on my tests. Like,
I didn't give a fuck. I didn't do any prep work. I did nothing. All I did was go to the fucking. I went to the fucking classroom with my mint smelling like fucking pencils and bubble gum and mint gum. Fun fact, dude. Mint does something with your brain. I don't remember.
When you chew it or something, it can help you remind. Yeah, remind you of something.
Sort of.
No.
The smell of
your
study.
How about shut the real technique for all you schoolgoers? Real technique, study before bed. That stays in your head overnight and like replenishes the next day. It's insane. It's like a chug splash.
Study before bed.
chug splash of knowledge.
That is so
you got chug splash. Oh, viewers at home.
It's crazy.
Knowledge.
If you have a test, chug splash.
Viewers at home, this is coming from the kid who got a 60 on his AP Calc exam.
You don't study. You can't.
This is what you're supposed to do if you want to pass the test. You chug 3-4 locos and then you start studying and you'll
learn. No. You gotta drink 4 soju bottles and then after that, spin 3 times, take some edibles and then.
And then put your left foot in and then take your left foot out.
Yeah,
dude,
do the hokey
soju
pokey.
Is fucked. Soju is actually fucked.
There's a ghost that was trying to undress you.
Have you guys?
There's a ghost like trying to. Whoa! Hey, too much shoulder there. Right,
have you guys ever had like really smart friends that would cry getting really good grades?
What?
I would always
cry when they got good grades.
Like my friend, he got a 2390 on the old SAT and cried.
Dude, all of my friends from California all got perfect scores on the ACT, 36, like. The California education system is so good.
Okay, can we pause that? Viewers at home.
I didn't see what happened.
Grunt just snapped like glass. A plate in half.
I don't know what the fuck that was. What even is that? That's
it
glass.
Just snapped in half. What was that? What is that?
What is that? It's just glass.
The ring light cover.
Oh my
dude,
God.
Dude, I was bending it. It was making a noise. It was like.
What did you what is that what you do? If you like step on ice, like an ice lake, and you like keep on going, it makes a crinkle sound. You keep going.
I can't wait until that is in the entire podcast audio for the whole time. Is Grung bending his light?
No,
his
that
ring
was
light.
Really one
no,
time.
I couldn't hear it. That was the only time that was in when it shattered.
All I
didn't
heard
hear
was
it at all. Maybe it picked up. I don't know, but I didn't hear it at all until it shattered.
Dude, I got jump scared like 2 times today. I was on my phone in the bathroom at a restaurant, and then someone walked in, and then I literally like jumped so hard. I don't even know why. I was acting like I had something to hide.
What were you doing in the bathroom?
I was peeing.
Why would you ask him what he's doing in the bathroom?
You just asked a high school kid what he was doing in the bathroom.
So you're telling me you're on your phone peeing?
I do that.
No, I was sitting in front of the sink checking my phone.
Oh, I pee while on the phone.
I peed, then went to wash my hands.
In public? Then I checked my phone. You know what? I'm going to let y'all motherfuckers know right now. I'll be looking at some tweets while I pee.
I sit down to pee.
I see every single tweet anyone ever tags me in.
I do sit down to pee. No, I've never seen
anyone pee. Sitting down to pee is better for your bladder.
Exactly.
I don't give a fuck.
There you go. There you go. No.
Yummy, you're a fucking yummy, strawberry. Yo,
yummy, yummy, yummy.
Look up a squatty like, potty, for, yummy.
Look up a squatty potty.
I don't give a
if you
fuck.
Angle your body at 45 degrees, it's better for your bowels.
I pee fine, you fucking pansy. I pee just fine. Squatty potty. I stand up like a man and I piss fine.
Look, Tanner, can you yell so that...
You gotta bend your knees at a 45 degree angle to pee!
No, you don't.
Yes, you do.
No. So you guys have little wieners. Listen, pee and sit down.
Look up a squatty potty. They exist.
Up, yummy.
I don't give
yummy
a fuck. I ain't a bitch.
Yummy is far too manly to sit down on the toilet to pee.
You know what? That's right. Because it's comfortable, it's my time.
Don't
I like looking
at listen to Yummy. Look at what he's wearing.
The only time I've ever sat down to pee
he's fruity. He's is when fruity. I thought, hey, what the hell? Oh
I thought
God.
I had to prove I sat down, I farted, I peed, and I got up.
He's in a strawberry outfit.
Yummy, do you ever poop without having to pee?
What the fuck?
No,
what?
That's not possible.
Okay, okay. Yeah, I have a genuine question. Have
yeah,
ever
I poop without
peeing. At the same time?
What? No,
you
don't.
Super
have you ever sneezed and the sneeze forced the crap out?
I've sneezed and burped and peed all at the same time.
That's called the Holy Grail.
What?
No, sneezing while peeing hurts. It's not, you're not meant for ooh. That.
Like, yeah, you cut
it's
it
like,
off.
It's like too it's much like, force. It's like the hose is going to rip open.
Yeah. Ow!
Wait, have you ever forced? Yeah, have you ever forced your pee and it burns?
People talk.
You have gonorrhea, dude.
Like I can feel it. Whatever people
okay,
talk about.
Listen, community timeout. Timeout.
Listen.
Timeout. Timeout. No. 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 Timeout. Shut up.
What?
There are three different conversations happening. It's like a lunch table.
Yeah, Nick has gonorrhea.
We're like lunch club.
I do
like.
Have
he just said. Like he just said. Club. Does it ever burn when you pee?
No, like, I said when you force it out, doesn't it
you
burn?
You have an STD.
No, yes, because like, it's going too fast.
Too fast, like, it's burning. Really it's like hot.
You guys have weak penis too.
You push it out. You go to the bathroom and force pee out of your dick and watch it.
I do it all the time.
Whenever you pee and you're really dehydrated, it feels like you're about to faint when you're peeing.
That's not a real
what
thing.
What is wrong with you guys? Dude, you guys have health problems.
It's when you lay down for a long time.
I don't resonate with that one. I don't know. You get lightheaded.
Sometimes when I pee, my balls hurt. I'll be real if we're going
to
be honest.
That's not
no, that happened to me too. That happens.
One time I fainted and my grandma did not help me up. I smacked my head on the floor. No, seriously. I was lightheaded and I get up after
and
literally
your wiener
passing
was
out. No, my wiener wasn't out.
Your dick was out?
One time I was mowing the lawn and I ran over a dog turd and it flew and hit my shoe and I went inside and got mad.
Wait, what are you doing right now?
What?
Okay, I have a serious question. Do you think if a bird poops during a hurricane, it'll spin around, it'll get like to a force that's so deadly, if it hits a person, a tornado, and then it goes around and hits a person so hard that it'll like knock him out and kill him?
I don't think a tornado.
Why does it have
no
to be
velocity.
Bird poop? Why can't it be like a rock?
Because you don't imagine bird poop killing somebody.
I don't think birds know when it's coming and they leave early.
Yeah. But still, no.
The pickup shop.
Okay, yes, okay, this bird was sleeping, Isaac. This bird was asleep.
Oh, this bird was
birds don't poop in their sleep.
The only way that would happen is if it froze. If it was liquid, it just go and didn't hit it.
Oh, like it'll spread out like a buckshot.
Have you guys ever been pooped on by a bird?
No, but one time on my car, I had like a 9-inch white streak of shit from like Godzilla bird.
One time I was mowing the grass and I ran over a dog turd and it hit my shoe.
What'd you say?
Your doctor came on your shoe?
Huh?
What'd you say?
Just keep repeating the same story over and over again from the animated video that we saw.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to the person who made the animated video that we saw.
That was a little interesting. Listen,
when we were mowing the lawn and we told a story.
Yeah, we were telling stories about mowing lawns. And
shout out you,
it.
Brother.
Unix. Unix.
How do you know it's a brother? You.
Yeah.
Sister?
You it's are
really an
animator.
Oh.
Hell. It's a really good.
We all loved
that
it.
That was so inclusive.
Can we link that in the description? Somebody said that to Cam. We're linking it.
Yeah.
So that was really funny.
Definitely check out that clip. And we would love more. We would actually love more. That shit's so fucking fun.
Yeah. Loved it. There was just an animated video of a podcast clip. It was really good.
Here's my contribution. Every time someone makes an animated video of us doing podcast stuff, I donate $1 to charity.
And if you,
that's a lie.
You're a liar.
You're a liar.
What are you doing? Liar.
No, I have a confession to make. I have a confession to make.
What?
It just kind of reminded me of that. Back when I was on Xbox, every single time my Xbox would have a problem connecting to the Wi-Fi, I would always pray to God that if he would connect my Xbox back to the internet, I would donate 25 cents to the church, and it would work every time, and I would never donate money to the church.
Dude, I did the same thing, but it's like me going to church because I've never gone.
Look at that necklace on your neck. Look at that necklace you're wearing.
He hit that thing so fast.
He hit that so fast. You're going to hell. You see who you're talking to, young man?
Dude.
You're going to hell.
When I was a kid, I thought I was like mentally deranged.
Let me explain.
No, leave it at that.
I gotta explain. Okay, so I used to run cross country when I was in like third, fourth grade. And when I would get really tired, I would I would imagine my family was dying at the finish line and I had to go save them.
Fucking Vin Diesel.
Oh my God.
Saving Private Ryan.
He's like, I imagine my grandfather at war and I have to run and save him.
No, that's real. I would always think like, okay, I would always like prepare if my mom died. I'm like, all right, how am I going to act around them? How am I going to act? What am I going to say? What am I going to do? I'd always take steps and just in case any of my parents died.
Like something really sad. When I was a kid, I think this was like fourth or fifth grade. I asked my mom like, what should I do if you ever got in a car accident and you almost died? And she's like, why would you think of that? We're like going to school. Like it was just like a normal day. And I asked her like, what should I do if you like get in a car crash and you get flung out the car? And she's like, I don't know how to answer that. I was like out of the blue.
I remember.
I was like, I'm really sorry. I don't know.
Interesting thoughts be winning sometimes.
She's like, don't think about that.
Dude, I remember, that's my stepdad. I remember I asked my stepdad, and I was like, if my mom dies, do I have to live with you?
You had a big frown on your face. Do I have to? Do I have to do that?
I'd rather be homeless, please.
I'd rather be with her than kill me, too.
A little wholesome moment with me and my mom. I had asked her, this is before I understood how death worked. I asked her if when I died, could she wait before burying me so I could ask God for more time on the planet?
That's cute.
Yeah.
That sucks.
That's actually
wow. I'd beat your ass if I was your parent. Like, I swear to God.
I can't wait till you get hit by a train and you're like begging for mercy from God. And we're like sitting there like, oh my God.
Begging for mercy. Overwatch.
That's not what she does.
Pressy.
You're like, heroes never die.
You actually look like Mercy.
No, there is Mercy. Wait, that should be the thumbnail for this video.
Mercy is at home. If you don't know.
Dude, what the fuck? Why does Grunk have a barricade at the back of his room?
I don't know.
Grunk has all of his shoe rack in his living room.
What is he? Like, he's trying to flex his drip.
Whenever Grunk moves out of his house, I imagine him having like a stick with like a bag, and that's it.
Those are his Yeezys right there.
Like one piece hat.
Yeah, they are.
Oh, what is he doing?
What is Chopper doing right now?
Chopper, viewers at home, Chopper's walking around.
His dog is peeing on a water bottle.
His dog is peeing in the house.
Eating
on a pee.
Speaking of peeing, I want to go back to the topic of us peeing.
I don't want
to
go back.
Yeah, you guys have pee problems.
I had poop problems growing up.
I had
poop
problems as well.
Nick, it's been like 8 podcasts. You've told us a story about the time you pooped your fucking pants. I don't want to hear it again.
Wait, you guys want to hear the time that I was supposed to force out a fart?
No, I don't want to hear the time.
The first time you thought you had to fart? What?
Let me guess. Your first time masturbating, you came to like Lego Ninjago, and then that was like, and then
it was. That's a good story.
Okay. That is a pretty good story.
Listen, that was by accident, first and foremost.
It was Bionicles, I thought.
No, it was Ninjago. I knew it was by accident. I didn't know.
And who
did
you come to? Was it Zane?
Why do you know that character name?
It's the blonde hair. No, that's the blue one.
Lloyd, I think it just happened to be
Lloyd. Oh, that's the worst one to come to.
Why the fuck would you be really coming to a dude to named Lloyd?
You came to Lloyd?
Dude, it wasn't that way, bro. It was not that way. I'm not explaining this story, especially with my face cam on. That's not
explaining. You never talked about that?
I did in a Tuxford video.
Oh, you came to Lloyd on a touch
hey,
for video?
I uploaded that to shit too, dude.
Oh, did you?
Oh.
Yeah. Nah, that was a weird time.
Oh. Girl, not me doing that.
Oh.
But,
okay, well, Nick,
I used to look up WWE
now.
Kissing montage.
No.
Dude, okay. They would tease the fuck out of us, man. I'll keep it $150.
Dude, they were giving... Okay, I'm not going to say that.
Whoa.
Say it. No, you can say it.
Whoa.
No, it's illegal. But they were giving me bone.
Oh! Cam 3204, he always flies off the rails.
What the fuck?
You are not going to heaven, my boy.
Dude, you
are not going to heaven. It's not my fault. WWE gave me a when I was heaven. Six.
I'm calling all my angel
grave
friends.
Digger give you a
what the fuck? Heaven.
No, it was yeah.
Undertaker.
They
Undertaker.
Get two girls in bikinis,
oh.
And they're like, yeah, start fighting each
like
other.
He's like talking like, big, like talking like Undertaker versus Triple H.
Undertaker.
Triple H. Undertaker. Batista comes
Cena.
In. Yeah, and John Cena.
I was like, made me laugh.
Moyo.
He would be like, fucking blow water everywhere, and they would just like kick somebody's ass for no reason and then leave. Like, that was it. That was all WWE.
Remember when Donald Trump was on WWE.
Day and then leave.
Huh?
Donald Trump wasn't WWE. You guys absolute ass handed to him by the Great Khali or someone.
The Great Khali. Dude,
Donald Trump is a big ass.
Who is the guy with the mask? The little short one? The Mexican
Rey Mysterio.
Guy?
Rey Mysterio.
Rey Mysterio, baby.
That's
my hero.
Larry, that's who you should dress up as for Halloween.
Wow.
Rey Mysterio?
Why?
It'd be accurate, because it'd be accurate.
Whoa, why would it be accurate?
Because the height?
Because of the height, and not because my friend Larry has to be Mexican today?
Because he's also Hispanic.
Remember Jeff Hardy?
Dude.
Yeah.
And you do the swan.
Good segue, Nick.
Thank you.
I remember Jeff Hardy. I don't want to talk about Triple H anymore.
You guys are in unison.
I love Jeff Hardy.
Jeff Hardy's great. I feel like Jeff Hardy... Holy
Jesus. Tanner looks like an Overwatch character skin right now.
Why'd he get up?
Heroes never die.
I feel like if you were any hero, you'd be May. You just have so
never
much
die.
To beat. Oh, you are May.
I am May. Look.
May you please suck my wiener now, is what I mean to say.
Dude, I heard Overwatch characters are like really bad now. Like, May doesn't even like freeze anybody. A Doomfist is like ass.
Doomfist turned into a tank.
Just he turned into a tank and
is that
like,
a girl or a guy?
Doomfist is a guy.
Do you think Doomfist is a woman?
Yeah. Whoa. What makes you say it's not?
Oh!
Come on.
You're right. My
listen
bad.
To the word Doomfist. Does that sound feminine?
I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, kind of.
Like
why
like
would
gay,
I assume?
Like a gay porn star.
Doomfist. Huh? Yeah, like he fists all of his
he
partners.
Fists men. He puts his big fist in people's butthole.
I love that Grunk is just wholesomely eating Jello.
I know, Grunk. You are so Baba.
You're Baba
baby today.
These videos.
Chomper, you're so Baba.
That's a grown man, by the way, ladies and gentlemen.
Chomper, look at your little paws, Chomper.
Okay, damn, I'm Cam, a grown ass start playing Spring in My Step.
Yummy, you are 37. You're wearing that.
Yummy, pushing 40. He's
Larry, you're a grown ass man without a driver's license.
Yummy's
dressed up as a girl.
Like, look at his work.
Yummy. Lay off
go,
the
like,
guy.
To the time. I think it was really funny how we were all talking about who's going to heaven and hell. And then, like, it was just like, fucking Tara's like, I'm a nun. And then Larry's like, I'm an angel. And then fucking Yummy was like, I'm mentally deranged. And he has like a fucking goddamn strawberry costume.
I was mentally deranged as a child.
I think I was.
I don't think so.
Dude, I busted my head open a bunch of times. My brain's damaged.
Ew.
I think we already said this on the podcast, but wasn't it like when
I mean
you didn't get your way, you would slam your head on like the...
No.
Like,
oh, that was different, but I did do that, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
I did that. But no,
dude, pavement.
My actual like head has bled 5 different times.
It explains a lot, honestly.
Just like a bunch of childhood, getting
is that why you're
hurt.
So mean all the time?
I'm not mean, you're just a baby.
Ooh. Okay, you come back. One head force trauma over here.
Dude, Yummy does this thing where he goes. He just looks around the fucking room.
Like,
it's the funniest
it's like
thing.
A laugh
he's like,
track is supposed to be playing.
He looks like a robot sometimes, dude. It's like automated.
Oh my god,
you're a fucking animatronic, man. You're like,
yeah, you are. Yeah.
I'm looking at everybody's faces. Sometimes I'll laugh, and then you guys will be like,
"Why'd you laugh like that?"
I don't know why you guys make fun of me so
much.
Like,
oh, we did it again.
Yeah.
Did it again.
Stop. You guys got me in a fucking loop. I want to take Quaaludes with Bill Cosby.
We know you want to turn your head.
Do it again.
But this is what it, this is the formula. Punchline, turn, turn,
turn, turn,
turn,
everyone laughs.
Turn.
The crowd goes watching.
Point,
turn, 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 laugh, laugh, laugh. Stop. Topic. Dude. How did that happen, Yomi? Was that trauma?
What, my head?
Huh?
What?
Yeah, your head.
What, my thing where I'm looking at people?
Yeah.
Shit.
Are you seeking for validation?
I don't know, bro.
Right now, bro.
You kept doing that in San Diego. You're like,
it was funny.
Every 8 seconds you would do it.
Because it was funny.
There's like one minor inconvenience and Yomi would look right at me and do that face.
We were all crammed into like this Uber car. We, like people kept going like super quietly like, and we just hear like from the front seat,
are you serious right now, baby?
There was one time we were going to, it was like midnight, and we were going to the beach, and then we were in the car, like, what the fuck was that?
I was trying to mute to cough, and I just played the songs.
I was like, where was who did that?
I'm sorry, I tried to mute.
No, leave that shit in.
I thought you were like, pretend if I was asleep. No,
yeah, leave that shit in.
I was trying to mute to cough, and now my cough is gone.
It's like that clip of Patrick, he's like,
Luigi when he opens the book.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my god, I'm sorry. Holy keep going with your story.
Uber. We're Ubering to a beach, and this we kept so doing funny. This stupid fucking. It was when the mafia joke started. Yeah, like the little.
Yeah, I don't know, boss. Yeah, what do you think? Wake me up when I care.
Wake me up when I care.
Not my first rodeo. Yeah.
There were so many. That guy was the driver was so quiet.
He did not say a word the entire time. We like apologized. We're like, sorry.
He's yeah,
like,
Isaac was in front of apologizing okay. the whole time.
And then yeah, I was just true. Like, I was being considerate.
Yeah, I did. So what?
Yeah, like, yeah. I did. So what? Can I do it again
over,
too?
We were going over the bridge, and I was like, guys, look at the skyline. That's all of San Diego. And Sandra was like, well, it's just concrete and glass. Why would I care?
Why would I care?
It's been there for a while. I don't give a fuck.
It's really funny.
Yeah. Oh,
can I change the topic for a second?
Yeah, back to something you can relate to. Let's go.
Yeah, so childhood. Can you guys explain to me like a childhood time where you're like really sad, like you lost a game or something like that? Because I was just thinking
puppy,
about this.
My puppy got beheaded. And I was like really depressed after that because it was fucked up.
Look at Nick's face.
Are you fucking for real? Are you serious or is that like slash? Are
you
slash?
Why do you think he's serious?
Are you slash serious?
He's
right
not
now, bro.
Serious at all.
I'm serious.
You're not I'd serious. I'd behead both of your puppies if you had two of them.
I'd behead that fucking
okay,
horse.
Okay, so anyway, I lost my game. It was called Surf's Up on the DS. I lost it in a fucking hotel. That was a sad memory. All right, Tanner, your turn.
What?
That's it? That was a joke. Well, not joke, but a story time. And bro said beheading a fucking dog. How do you even come back from that? Even if it was a joke.
Behead a pigeon or something.
I mean, I didn't really get sad as a kid. Like, my chihuahua died, but he got
you
ran
had
over.
A chihuahua?
Like, oh, yeah. Dude, that reminds me. I had a dog. His okay. name was Charlie. Charlie ran into the interstate by Starbucks outside our house and got fucking owned.
You were the yeah.
Why'd you bring a dog to Starbucks?
If
you bring
a dog we to weren't Starbucks, at Starbucks. We lived, my old house had this really, really big ass yard and another big yard, but we fenced it off and Charlie's cock ass
broke out
and jumped over
oh.
the fucking fence and ran into the road by that Starbucks and just got.
You should have gotten him that puppy chow mocha cocoa thing.
Yeah, I was too young. Cone? I was too young
Wait,
to care.
How
I
old
think
was the dog?
Oh, it was a puppy. Well, not like a puppy. It was like, you know, like
Wait,
two.
So he didn't feel it?
Nah.
Yeah, no. You only
yeah,
puppies start
are
feeling
indestructible.
Stuff at three. Yeah.
Puppies don't even have brains. Like,
exactly.
Unlike monkeys where like they hold on to the wires and they die instantly.
Those monkeys are insane.
They go and jump on electrical wires and then fall, like doing a fucking woohoo move.
Krug, that's gonna be a gift, dude. I really hope that turns into a
yeah,
gift.
Do that right now.
There's probably a gift right now.
The camera
as we speak.
And just ragdolls.
And one time, a monkey took my Jimmy Choo chain and he ran with it. Shut up.
All you do is
Jimmy Choo has never looked at you in your life. He knows who I am. Shoot. Shout out. Big shout out, Jimmy.
Johnny Dang made me a necklace
Johnny
of,
Dang.
Of a vagina.
All right, Kat, put the clip.
Nobody's going to know. Nobody's going to know that.
Van Bala. Dude,
I just checked my DMs and there's just a gold chain of a fucking pussy just hanging there. Yeah.
I'm like, what? Oh, yeah.
I literally thought it was like two pieces of metal slammed together, but then I played the video and I was like, oh, it all came together.
Yeah, like the whole, the clit was out and everything.
It was just all gold hanging from a chain.
It was like, the tweet read, it said like, man in the fucking wherever the fuck loved his girlfriend so much that he got her his girl's like pussy chained.
Do you think they had to like sit down and resin or whatever to like get that?
I think what the fuck? What do you think a sculptor?
How do you know
a sculptor?
Yummy. How do you think?
Are you a
pocket
pussy necklace
are made?
Connoisseur?
Yummy.
Don't,
yeah.
I don't know
it. Yummy. Yeah, pocket pussies are made that way. They like fill up and then they like let it harden and they pull
who
it
the
out.
Fuck is Philip? Are we?
That shit was the bottom ass. Like, what call?
Who the fuck is Philip? And why is he like putting stuff?
Why is he looking at that girl's Tanner? Pussy?
Why is he looking at that
Tanner?
Girlfriend?
Yeah, Tanner.
Are we gonna get demonetized?
No, we're fine.
Okay.
YouTube manual reviewer. Words. If you're 40 minutes into this podcast, you're welcome for the entertainment. Oh my dick, bro.
Seen a strawberry man say, "Holy fuck!"
I look like a medieval, dick, like an elf. Like
you do. You look
woods.
Like an executioner. Like you're about to kill somebody.
You're like Clash Royale.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're the knight.
Wow. Why was everything a song back in the day? Like when people were mining, they were always like being like synced up and like making a song.
It was like when they were talking then, about a girl.
It was back
there
when the Great
no
Depression
AirPods.
Happened.
There was no AirPods, Larry.
iPods did not exist.
Miners now wear AirPods.
Miners?
What the hell are you talking about?
Miners!
Oh, what?
So just saying, miners is bad. Man.
The ones who mine.
When the miners are down in
the
hole. The
ones
who
miners.
You think they got AirPods in?
Wait, you're way too excited about that.
Wait, Larry,
bro.
Pretend you're getting blown back. Miners!
Oh, wait, through Grunk's ear.
Well, one more time,
wait,
Tanner.
Hang on,
one more
go,
time.
Go again.
Don't do it again.
Wait, I lagged.
Miners!
What?
Was there some lag going on?
No, he did that with his.
No, I know. I was just like trying to point
like,
to the
he's
joke.
Like, he's
hey.
Like, wait. Miners!
Hey.
Okay.
Dude, this is fucking stupid.
This is the...
All right, I'm stating a new rule. Miners, D&I, no to not watching the podcast anymore.
Do not interact.
I think this podcast like beats off the other podcast that was goofy off.
Dude, you can't follow up what we were just talking
this
about.
Podcast, no!
Brian asked what we were just talking
this,
about.
Okay, I think this podcast... This? All right, listen, I think this podcast beats out the other goofy off.
I think this podcast
Oz.
Jerks off other podcasts.
I think this podcast jerks off the other goofy off one.
This blows
this
out.
This one's goofier than all the other ones.
Yeah.
This one's, it's always like out. The random episode. That's
this
just
is the cornball number eight podcast.
Yeah, this is
bro,
emoji everywhere podcast.
Cornballs think they all that.
I think it's way better when we don't have topics because we just start talking about the stupidest shit ever.
I never got to tell my sad story.
Oh, yeah. Oh, say your sad story.
Yeah, 4 years ago.
I don't think I have one.
Yeah, okay, I don't get sad.
Oh,
I haven't cried since
I have one. I was like 6 or 7. I went to SeaWorld. I was walking on the curb and the ground at SeaWorld is like, all the rocks are glued together and shit. That's like the pavement, dude. I don't even know how to explain it. It's just a bunch of rocks and garbage. Okay. And I slipped off the curb. Boom. Right on my elbow. Boom. Right on, boom. Right on my elbow. Boom. And I started bleeding and I was just crying like a little
was
bitch.
That, was that like several times or were you just like putting
it? I was like, boom, 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 boom.
Oh, okay.
I remember I got a scab on my elbow and I picked it and it tore all the way up my arm.
Ew! What the fuck? What are you talking about? I never picked scabs as a kid unless they were like in my face, like
I
in my
them
eyes.
And ate them because they were fucking nutritious.
I thought it would heal
damn,
faster.
Damn, son, like, where'd you get that?
Yeah, wait, I have one there too. I
see that's the Avatar symbol.
Yeah,
you're the
staff
Avatar
infection.
Airbender.
That's staff infection.
No,
yeah,
that's ringworm. Because I was a kid and I fell and it busted open. I fell on my scooter. It busted open once. And then it's
busted.
Don't tell me you faked it.
It's scat, no, it's scat over. And then I fell again and I landed on like the bark of a tree and then it reopened.
How do you fall on the bark
of a tree?
And
then it started to
What did
again.
You do? I heard you go on the ground
rink,
now you're on the bark.
And then I went to the roller rink and then I fell again and went. And then it
doesn't
open
doesn't
again.
Picking scabs make it heal faster? So like it keeps
no.
going.
Yeah, it does.
Like over and over again. So like
no, it
goes
all
the way.
Yeah,
and then more healing.
Doesn't that make it scar? Does that make it scar?
You're ruining God's plan of healing if you
God's
pick a scab.
God's okay, well, God made some really delicious snacks on my body to eat.
No, there's no way you ate your scabs.
It's like a pepperoni.
Dude, I used to eat my boogers until my grandma yelled at me.
That's the worst thing. I'd rather eat my scabs than fucking boogers.
Them all.
Do you have greener or white boogers?
White.
They're probably fucking green.
Like,
and he
pissed
was
on me. It's
purple. I just didn't know where to put it, so I ate it, and then I got yelled at. Was that simple?
If you eat, dude, all right, put it in the comments. Would you rather eat your scabs or your boogers?
Or your belly button? I'll make a little sandwich out of it. I'll put my booger in between two big scabs, and then eat it.
Okay, who's done this, right? Who's done this? You hold on to your AirPods, right? And you put it back in.
Stop.
And then somehow you put your finger in your mouth and now you taste the earwax.
Ew, shut up. Why would you put your finger in your mouth?
That's even better.
Dude, I've had some crazy earwax before.
Me too.
Oh my God. I remember that one where you flushed out your earwax. You know, it was like a ball. It was like a bowling ball.
I had to squeeze water in my ear, like hot boiling water. Dude, it was so hot. I did it and I was like, and then I got fucking dizzy and I started stumbling around my house.
Oh,
because I scorched my eardrum.
The eardrum got fucking boiled alive.
Yeah, and it fucked my equilibrium.
Yeah. You do not put boiling water in your fucking ears.
Yeah, don't do that. But an actual canal-sized piece of earwax, like a tube, it came out of my ear, dude.
It was like a perfect, fucking structure of the inside of your earlobe.
It was like a curved fucking, fucking tube, like a log of shit.
Imagine there was like little holes in it, and they're like little men, in your ear, and it showed it.
You're like, let go of me, huh? Put me back in there.
It was a little anthill when you pour metal down the anthill.
Oh,
that's cool. Those videos are cool.
Have you seen the videos of like these people pulling whatever is in their nose?
Yes. Like, dude.
I don't watch anything like that.
Okay. I have a question.
You ever seen the Zit Doctor?
If you had an Audi, would you ever pull out your Audi?
What?
Dude, I can't. If you press in on your belly button,
you can't do that.
It hurts.
Impossible.
Does that make you nauseous?
It makes me really uncomfortable and gross.
It hurts my dick.
It does hurt my dick too when I press on it.
It does. It's like there's something connected to it.
Wait,
no, it's the
girls have an equivalent of getting hit in the balls?
Yeah, they have a bone down there.
Punched.
They have a bone down there.
They have pussy balls.
Do they feel the same thing we do?
Oh,
pussy balls.
I don't know.
It's impossible.
No, they don't have balls. girls do have a vagina.
That's how you coughed every day.
That's how you coughed all in TwitchCon.
I did it on purpose so you guys.
Drunk got yummy and XQC sick at TwitchCon. That's real.
I did. I spit on XQC's mouth.
You're mean for that.
Hey, listen, I'd spit in XQC's mouth if I could, too.
That's my
with
ass,
his
bro. Stop.
What?
Oh, that was
I had a sad story. Oh, yeah. You remember on that beach in San Diego when I found that full sand dollar just alive? It was like this big.
How was it alive?
I don't know if you know, but you gave it to me and I actually spent it on the Coca-Cola.
What'd you do? What'd you do with it?
I put it in my wallet for safekeeping. I got to the airport. I opened my wallet. It was in dust. There's like dust and in pieces everywhere.
Those are fragile.
You open it like,
I know.
The sand dollar was like the cave inside.
Dude, he's in
a cardboard
mango
box.
In your wallet? You saw that dried mango?
I ate it.
Did you really?
He took a bite. He did.
I took a bite and I ate it.
You did. And then, well, there's a hair on it. There's an actual hair on
it. Guys
are,
why is everyone freaking out?
Because
it's a dried mango. It's already dried.
It was in there for like 2 months after the trip.
It was pretty bad.
It was being preserved by the wallet.
I showed it to everybody that I knew in Austin. I was like, you want to see my dried mango? It was like,
that was your party trick.
It was like a death blow.
If you have any pimple problems, get this device. It actually cures it instantly.
All right, how about you tell the class?
No, get on the spot treatment.
No. Get Gel 10.
No. Neutrogena. What is
it? I had one right there. I put it on. It's gone the next day.
Syphilis.
No
damn.
If you guys have syphilis problems,
dude, I've
sex.
Never had acne once on my face.
Yeah,
really?
I've been really lucky too.
I don't really get acne. I don't know why. My dad's skin's oily as fuck, but mine's like
dude,
perfect. I don't know what it is.
There's people at my school that do Accutane. I think Accutane is like not good for you at all. Like, Accutane is like
it nukes your whole face.
Accutane is the equivalent of like the whitening toothpaste.
Literally, if you don't eat anything before you take it, you literally like die. Like, you can't function as a human being.
You start growing hair in weird places if you take
Accutane. I can pull my nipples out right now.
Yeah, it actually expedites puberty and 10Xs and you get a lot of butt hair.
And like, it makes your lips all chapped and gross. Ugh.
Dude, Accutane can literally make you depressed and like make you want to kill yourself.
It's crazy. Like,
that's
real.
That's like every drug, though.
I guess but Accutane is pretty rough. I had my sister did it. My aunt did it too, and they were like, really. My aunt had like really bad acne.
Tanner,
at
we're
one
gonna
point.
Get fucking
like as an adult.
Stop it.
My nipples aren't out.
Yeah,
don't
like
worry.
As an adult, and like it does really well, but it really can fuck you up.
Yeah,
mentally.
you have to go through it. Yeah. In order for it to do well.
My cousin did too. I think it can help remove scarring too, if I'm not mistaken.
I'm surprised I don't have scars like on my jawline.
Just proper pimples, same. Man.
Did you have a lot of acne here on your cheeks?
No, I didn't really have a lot of acne, but like I would get it occasionally and I would never like treat it with any kind of anything.
Did you just pop it?
Yeah.
That's fine. Right?
Yeah, that's
like, yeah, I would pop it, but then I'd rub at it sometimes too.
I only would get one debilitating pimple that was like the biggest thing I've ever seen in my entire life. And once I popped it, I'd bleed out and get dizzy. And then I'd like lay down. Like, that's literally what would happen. I don't know. I don't know. My mom saw one on my back and it was like the size of like a nickel.
No.
And then she like popped it.
You probably had a fucking cyst back there and popped and it came out like as marbles and oysters.
Stop.
Oh my god.
I literally
god.
Like passed out. Just
like dumping out.
Oh yeah, fish and like fish bones and green legumes.
Skulls and like you're bones. Making yummy puke.
Yeah.
I had to cough.
Oh, sorry. My bad.
Yeah.
No, I think like real. The worst pain is like literally ingrown hairs if you don't get it right.
I've never had one.
Just get like a fucking little thing and you pull it.
Oh, have you guys ever had like a fucking horrible like blackhead on the corner or like a pimple on the corner of your nose?
That's the one that hurts most.
Ouch.
Or
like
right in the middle, right in between your eyebrows.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. Lower back is pretty painful.
Never had those.
I don't get acne like that, dude.
I don't have much acne either, but like sweating from the gym and stuff, I've gotten it pretty bad. Also, I shave my arms. And I get all in here sometimes, like pimples, like right inside of the crease, like maybe one or two.
What if it's like razor burn?
That is what it is.
That's
actually.
What it is. Yeah.
Yeah.
Razor burn.
It's like it's
when
like
I wipe up my back, I used to get acne on my middle back from when I would wipe.
Oh, what the hell is wrong with you?
That was the worst episode.
That should be the end of that discussion.
Oh my god.
Dude, I remember I took a picture. Maybe you guys remember this.
This is not a safe space.
Wait, no, yummy. You didn't.
Wait, it's called a joke, dude.
Wait, yummy.
I can see what you're saying is that you wipe towards your balls?
I wipe from my cooch all the way up.
Okay. Has anybody ever feared like they wiped up too far up and it's gonna like go up to their hair?
Yeah.
It's gonna have like a strip like all the way up
back. Yeah, all the time.
Imagine getting to your like middle back and you're like, dang, I'm going way too far.
you're like tailbone. You're like, oh shit, it's the stop sign.
This is the grossest. Stop sign.
This is the grossest podcast in the world.
You go up your spine, you're like, it's a bumpy hoe.
And like, your hair stands up because you kept going. It's like sticking up.
The poop like acted like gel. It spiked your hair straight up into a point.
I'm all out. I got a piece of...
This is bad. Larry, how can you talk about this, but you can't talk about eating mayonnaise?
I'll get him with this. Hey, Larry, imagine a really big back pimple and you pop it and then you put it on a piece of bread and eat it at the end.
And then mayonnaise is in a big bucket.
Mayonnaise gets all over you.
Mayonnaise, and ketchup, like, and pickle juice. Yeah.
Imagine, remember that guy that was cooking food in the dirty dishes? Have fun with that, thinking about it.
That's a bad one. That was a really bad one.
Okay, have you guys ever seen the poop drowned in like...
Wait, I just confused myself.
Was that even English?
This is how the
video went. The guy had like a luchador mask, right? And he was like drenched in shit.
What?
And he was covering himself up.
It was like a wrestler's mask, like an old, like Nacho Libre.
Rey Mysterio.
And he was like dressed and she was in the sewer. And he just had shit and he went under. He like went under and then went back up and he had a bunch of piles of poop with like corn. What the fuck are you talking about?
I tuned out.
This is like the second video I mentioned. Nobody fucking knows. And I'm going to get DMs and be like, oh, I know what you're talking about.
Dude. Actually, I know what you mean.
Actually, I have the video if you want it.
Oh my. Okay, I can talk about something. Can I talk? Okay. Stop laughing. I went to the amusement park here around me, and I kid you not, I paid $120 to ride four rides in one of the scary attractions because it was so expensive. I paid $5 for water
and
$20. I paid $20 for a cup of fries this big.
Ew.
Oh my god! I'm never going to an amusement park.
Well, do you have the ability to buy a Dash Pass?
I mean,
you fat ass motherfucker.
It'd be another $80.
You think DoorDash is the amusement park?
Dude, fairs, amusement parks, they're just the biggest scams. Watered down money grabbers, pieces of garbage. The worst thing.
Sometimes
movies are also the worst. Don't just like.
Sorry.
Movie theaters.
Dude, yeah. I'm not eating a fucking Panera Bread ever again. That shit's overpriced as hell.
What are you talking about?
Give me a discount. I got a small milkshake, a turkey chili bowl, and a sandwich, $27.
That's like, literally the same price as your cookout meal, I'm sure.
That's literally...
Are you fucking dumb?
That's like $7.
I'll argue
with cookout.
We went to cookout. We got a whole, like, three-tray meal. It was, like, $17.
See?
But also, they forgot an entire tray and gave me the wrong drink.
Oh, my God. Dude. They fucked up.
You should be the representative for cookout, yummy.
Literally, we went back to the house to eat it, and we opened it, and we were like, where's our third tray? And then we went back to the cookout and stood in the driveway. You. No, look, they did actually help. I have a picture.
Like, okay, what kind of food is at cookout? What kind of food is it?
Whatever you want, dude. What do you want right now? What do you want right now? I'll tell you if they have it.
This is us at the drive-thru talking to the guy. We're like, you gotta fix this.
You gotta fix this or we're gonna be pissed.
What do you want right now, Tanner? What are you hungry for?
Honestly, I could eat like, I could eat like Alfredo.
Lemon pepper wings.
All right,
lemon
pepper
wings. Okay, lemon pepper wings. Did I got lemon pepper wings?
No, they got that shit either.
They got cheese bites.
Are they like Sonic? They just have like any kind of bite size.
Exactly like Sonic. Yeah.
They're kind of like Sonic. But a lot cheaper.
I'm going to say cookout was not that good.
You got the worst thing you could get at cookout.
What do you want? Chicken quesadilla.
Yeah. That was an idiotic move.
That was a dumb move. Dude, every chicken quesadilla is ass.
Tell them about the burger.
That burger was some horse ass, my boy. That shit was some garbage, man. That shit overcooked ass, smash burger ass.
He ate the whole thing.
I'm the good burger. I'm with the good burger.
He ate the whole thing.
Burger.
What? Out of pack.
You ate the whole burger, you big fat ass. Oh, it's not that good.
it was okay. It was like a smash burger.
What the fuck?
You just lied. Guys, sorry. I backtracked and I lied.
You can't complain about a $5 meal, bruh.
It was a $5 meal.
That doesn't make a lot of sense.
I mean, they must know your name. You go there all the...
They must know you by name.
They actually know my credit card number.
Mm-hmm. They see a Honda Fit pull in and they're like, all right.
Yeah, they already have the order ready. Yeah. Here you go, Mr. Yummy.
Get the fry cooked ready.
All right, everybody. Station. Everybody get in line.
Station.
Everybody freaks out.
They hear the stars. Yummy starts ordering it. They're all flipping patties.
They pull out the biggest gun
like
they can find.
It's like slow motion. His lips are smacking as he's ordering.
The dump truck.
You get all like the condiments,
all the fries in the dump truck.
The coldest place for his large coke.
The crate opens up, like more burgers. He comes in, I like a triple blocky deluxe at a cookout. Make it on its third tray.
Let it swim.
Let it burn. Let it cry. Swim. I don't know. There you go. Let it swim. We ain't serving food. All right,
what's your guys' number one fast food restaurant?
Chick-fil-A is really good.
Why are we laughing?
Yeah.
Is it the pause? The awkward pause? Yeah. I was thinking.
Chick-fil-A.
Chick-fil-A is really good.
Everyone was thinking.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I wasn't thinking.
We're all thinking.
I mean, McDonald's is fine.
Can I be honest?
Fuck no, dude. I hate that piece of shit place.
McDonald's is ass.
McDonald's is like their food does not actually fill you up. It's like fluff. It's like it feels really good going down.
I like their McFlurries though.
You know like Wall-E?
No.
The robot?
The movie.
Yeah.
And everyone's in space and they're all in those fucking chairs and they're huge as fuck.
Yeah.
They're big. They're massive.
That's why I think McDonald's average customer, what they want it to look like, because they came out with like the most stupid, idiotic thing ever.
Okay, so we'll just do this in an hour.
We'll land there and see.
Nah, it was like a fucking turkey burger and a burger and a fish filet of fish for no fucking...
The sea, air, and land thing, right?
Yes, land, air, sea. Stupid.
Oh, they also had like the
land,
the
double, 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 double
X burger. That's what they called it.
I remember now. It was like, I literally said it the wrong order and Yummy corrected me.
Oh, dude, every time we talk about food, Yummy corrects it. Yeah, like, he knows every order.
Dude, some of you guys are dumb and not. Yummy can count everything.
I'm not counting that shit. I don't give a fuck about calories.
Yeah.
You guys are mentally ill. You'll be like, I haven't had enough macros today, and my microbiology chromosome food burger is too many macros, and I can't eat it.
And then you go,
and that's why our vertical is more than 2 inches.
And with
yummy.
A big ass drink and big ass fries. Thanks. I'll get
a super mega. 1v1 mean basketball, fatty.
I will. Oh, yeah, I'll cross you up.
I'll fucking get you.
Talking about me, Larry. He called me.
No. Oh,
I'll be real. 1v3, you
it's
guys.
It's because I told him his vertical is 2 inches. That's why he's calling me
yummy
fat.
Yummy will win in basketball. I'll be real.
I will win in basketball.
Against everybody. Maybe except Isaac.
Not when I deck him and then fucking take the ball and then shoot.
Hey, that's a foul. That's a foul.
We're playing street ball.
Not when I shoot him.
There's no rules in street ball.
Oh, you want to play street ball?
Let's play street ball.
Cross you up and pull your pants down, slurp your shit up, and then dunk on you, dog.
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna put your pants down, sling your ball on the dick, and now go up.
What?
What? What did he say? What was that?
I'm gonna pull your pants down and hop on your dick like a spring and dunk.
I'm gonna jump off your dick and I'm gonna dunk. I'm gonna jump on it like a backboard.
I'm gonna jump like.
I actually read this really interesting short story for English, and it was called The Bet, and this guy was this guy got
the fuck
he was like
bet?
He was like, I bet that I could survive 15 years in prison for $2 million.
I saw that. I know that short story.
And then he did it, but like in those 15 years he like read all these books.
He didn't want the money.
Gained all this knowledge. And then he like became a nihilist guy. It was like, nothing matters. All this knowledge I know, it doesn't matter. I'm just going to die. And like, it doesn't matter. And then he walked out 5 minutes before 15 years.
Oh,
and
yeah, that's right.
That's based. And like, that's freaking sweet.
I was like, he didn't want, dang. Moral of the story.
Yeah, no, that's like that's like the story of the cavemen with like the fire, and they saw like
the bit.
Shadows. And like they went
out. Carson, that made a book. It'd be called The Bit. It'd be called the Riz book. The W.
The Riz Bible.
Riz Bible.
I would make a cookbook called Good Eats. That's what I would do.
I feel like I would make a book called Good Eats with good people.
with good people.
I'd make a book called Big Puffer.
The Grizzy Bible.
When it gets silent, I look straight to you. I don't know why. You just look silly.
He makes faces every 2 minutes.
What if I move my...
You kind of remind me of that guy who was like trying to run for president and he had a boot in his head.
Who?
What? Johnny was Appleseed.
Was that
a boot? He had a boot
in his
head?
That guy fell asleep under trees.
Johnny Appleseed?
Yeah, Johnny Appleseed fell asleep under a tree and an apple hit his head.
His name was Vermin Supreme.
Yeah, I saw it on Barnyard.
Vermin Supreme. that's freaking... Heard of him? Albert. No, that's not Albert. Who is it?
Look.
Albert Nantucket.
No! Wait, that guy's fucking sweet.
Wait, who had an apple hit their head?
Isaac Newton? Isaac Y, guy.
Isaac Newton. Isaac Newton. The guy that invented gravity.
The guy that runs Russia.
Wait, who's the guy who found electricity?
Albert Isaac Newton.
I keep saying my favorite
Tesla. Franklin.
Tesla.
Nikolai.
Wasn't Edison?
No, Thomas Franklin.
Thomas Edison stole
it. Ben Franklin is a fucking fraud. He's a fraud. He copied Nikolai Tesla.
He did.
Thomas Edison.
Okay, I have to poop. Can we wrap it up?
No, we have to keep going.
The first part of the episode was like gibberish. We gotta keep going.
I still have to poop.
Chewie took like 3 minutes and now we gotta keep going. Mr. Beast. No poop, just leave. We don't need you here.
We don't need you.
We don't know when you're gone, so just go!
Did you actually start using your face cam but wear a mask or like put it like neck down?
I have to poop. This isn't a joke. It's not.
No, don't.
Answer my question.
I had to
What's your Chick-fil-A order?
And I didn't.
Dude, he didn't answer any of my questions that he
left. Yeah, he's very selfish like that.
Kick him off the podcast.
He is. Let's get him out of here.
Get him out, man.
What's your Chick-fil-A order, guys? Come on, guys.
I get an eight piece chicken nugget, medium fries.
That's the only thing you like, no.
Have you guys tried their new spicy grilled chicken sandwich? It's way too spicy.
You're a fucking
I'm serious, dude. It's way too spicy.
It's way too spicy.
You're like a fucking
It's way too spicy.
You're like a dream customer. Like, you know everything. You, like, know how to, like, tell people, like, what to get and shit. Like, you're an ad board for, like, fucking fast food.
I got a
fucking
did you eat today yet?
Don't ask that question. You know the answer.
I ate with the Papa.
Whoa.
Papa John?
Papa John's?
Yeah, I had Papa John's.
And what are you going to have tonight? Okay.
Probably Cookout or Taco Bell.
That's so bad. Like,
your metabolism has to That's be really so good.
But you have a nice ass kitchen, and all you do is eat like food out, dude.
You only spent $10,000 on his kitchen, and he just there.
No, actually, I did it.
It was $15K.
Before you come at me, Yummy, literally, I remember when he was buying his house, he's like, look at this fucking kitchen. I'm going to cook meals in here all the time, bro. It's going to be crazy. Stop looking at me like that, Yummy. Stop looking at me like that. And stop looking at me. And Larry, don't come at me. I was like, after not having a kitchen for such a long time, I just...
You built your kitchen with your bare hands, with your dad.
And then you moved out and you never used it.
I think I cooked in that kitchen like 2 times.
That's insane.
I'll cook in my kitchen before I cook
you
a meal.
Like, I'm gonna be cooking this bitch. I'm gonna learn how to cook and shit. I remember you saying like,
I'm gonna do cooking streams.
I'm gonna do all types of shit.
I told myself right before.
What happened?
I told myself
you did
right
one cooking
Twitch
stream.
Show.
I remember, and it was like spaghetti.
It was baking. I baked. I didn't even cook.
You
did.
You're a girl.
Wow.
Okay. Anyway.
Anyways.
Says
you strawberry fruitcake.
Why don't you cook like a man, like sear a steak or some shit in your kitchen on the cast iron?
How about
skillet?
You cook a sous vide with Guga?
All right, great. I want you to be like in that costume, saying like a really controversial take.
Controversial?
I don't know.
No, it's gonna be really bad. It's gonna be the true.
I don't know what to say.
It's better not to say it.
Wait, Yummy, right, you should do a
I'll
thing
think of something.
Controversial cooking with Yummy, and you just start saying controversial cooking,
just like a bunch of stuff.
Yeah, controversial cooking.
Okay, 107.
What timestamp was
it's
that?
It's a joke, just delete it. It's a,
no,
just
no,
delete
it.
It.
No, we can't. We can't, that's not even a good joke. That's...
I mean, we asked him to say something.
Yummy fixed it with, it's a joke.
It's a joke.
You're like, no, the one knows. No, it's
Yummy,
a joke.
Yummy was completely serious. And
wait, we can just bleep
reactions.
It. We can just bleep it. Like, it's like,
Yummy and then we're all out of that one.
Yeah, just bleep it. Just bleep it. Right. Guys, I said something really controversial. It was a joke, though. But totally, they shouldn't be able to do that, what I said.
All right, now say something not controversial.
Women should be able to choose the right to abort their baby.
Okay.
Yeah, there you go.
That's good. That's pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Didn't contradict the last thing you just said.
Nah, it was bleeped. I didn't hear what he said.
I don't know what he said either.
I don't even know it. I forgot.
Hold on. Everyone, wait.
Anyway, Larry, what about your fast food?
Welcome back to episode 20 of the podcast.
We went back 8 episodes
to 20. So we were like mowing the lawn. I got really fucking pissed.
Isaac went over a dog turd or something.
Yeah.
That was funny. And it flung in his ass. Man.
Anyway.
So I want to talk about one last thing real quick. All right.
Yeah.
One last thing. Right. And it's the fact that it is now officially fall time because the weather outside is perfect and beautiful. And that means everyone should go watch Over the Garden Wall. With your family and your friends and everybody you know.
Yo, Over the Garden Wall is better than possibly Adventure Time, I will say.
Over the Hedge?
No, okay, I wouldn't go that far. But
I'll go
the
that
most,
far.
It's the most far fall time show
it
ever.
It is perfect.
Absolutely. It encapsulates like, everything.
It's perfect.
Fall.
It's beautiful. The animation is beautiful. The songs, the thing, it's so good. It's
not
so
better than
fucking
Adventure
good.
Time,
is this a Ghibli film?
Might be. It's on. It's teetering. It's shorter, but it has so much substance.
You could literally watch all Over the Garden Wall in one night, like one afternoon.
Over There's the so hedge. Much substance in it. It's so good.
Over the Hedge.
Over the Hedge? We could watch Over the Hedge. What are you crying about?
Oh, he's
laughing.
Why are you crying? Oh.
What is a Ghibli film?
My ears hurt. Are you serious right now, bro?
My ears hurt so bad.
I was ringing after that. That was weird. I don't know.
What's a Ghibli film?
What's a Ghibli film? A Ghibli.
All right.
Isaac's not, he's not coming back.
I just realized
back.
That we could bro fist without Isaac. We don't need him.
We don't need him. Yeah. He's fake.
You
he's
think
fake.
Did he bro fist like still?
He doesn't. I don't think he does.
He's
just like,
he's just what he does. All right, guys.
He's
let's
a faker.
Mm-hmm. he's like,
yeah.
And then he plays his fucking silly video like, games, Toontown and Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yeah. He plays games on podcasts. It doesn't even pay attention.
Yep. He hates everybody. I'm pretty sure
he's like playing Overwatch. Click, clack, click, clack, click, clack, click,
he's
clack.
Like, so what's your guys' favorite restaurant?
What are you doing?
You like you jerk it off.
So, what's your guys' like?
I would never do that. I would never do that.
Fast food meal, because...
The Chick-fil-A chicken sandwich is way too spicy.
I really... So, I got cookout the other day, and it was $27, and it was a lot of food.
I think we should bro-fist it out. I think we should.
You don't want someone, me bro-fisting with this hand.
Someone's got to go end it on Isaac's computer, though.
Nah, he can, we can just leave it running for now.
We can just leave it running.
Running bro-fist. All right.
We'll be back.
Gamersubs 10% off. Gamersubs code 10% off.
Code group. Code group. Code group.